Hi, I am Pawan. I will be teaching you science. Today, I will be teaching you about 7th standard first lesson food components. In the previous lessons, we have talked about names of different food components and sources of the food components, and we also discussed about the test for conformation of carbohydrates and the test for fats, test for proteins. And today let us talk about roughages. Let us talk about what are roughages and sources of roughages and how to find the presence of roughages in the food items. Okay, now let us talk about roughages. What are roughages? Roughages are the dietary fibers. What are roughages? Dietary fibers. Roughages are what? Dietary fibers. So it's a fiber food. It's a fiber which is available in the food items. Dietary fiber in the sense, the fiber, it doesn't get digested itself, it makes others' food digested. You got the point? You just note this point. Dietary fiber, it doesn't get digested, it makes others' food digested. Understood, no? So this is the main important function of the roughages. And now let us talk about sources of roughages. What are the sources of roughages? Sources are like the availability of the roughages. Where these roughages are available? Roughages are available in vegetables, fruits and some grains like bran, shredded wheat and cereals, etc. And then roughages are also available in fruits. And what are the fruits? Name the fruits like berries, pumpkin, oranges, apples, banana and papaya, etc. So in various, in different types of fruits, roughages are available. Okay, and then, and what are the vegetables? The vegetable sources of the roughages in vegetables are leafy vegetables and raw vegetables. If you want to know about the leafy vegetables, for the presence of roughages is palak. It's a main rich fiber food in our daily foods. And vegetables, if you want to, vegetables like ribbed gourd, plain potato, sweet potato, and lady's finger, etc. These are the rich of fiber foods. So here, how do you find the presence of roughages? How do you find the presence of roughages? There is a very simple experiment that you can do it and you can find the presence of roughages. That you have to take the food among these food items and then you just crush them and you try to observe carefully, you will find fine strands or thread-like structures. These fine strands or thread-like structures are nothing but fiber. So as I already told you before, the fiber, main function of the fiber is that makes others' food digested, but it doesn't get digested. Understood, no? And this is this not only makes others' food digested, it strengthens the alimentary canal. It strengthens what? Alimentary canal. What does it mean? It improves the bowel movement. It stimulates the bowel movement. So then we will not suffer by any intestinal problems. You know, for example, the intestinal problem is constipation. You know what is constipation? Constipation is a health condition by which we trouble for free motion. Yes, have you got it? We trouble for free motion. In the sense, we trouble for free motion means this is a problem. Some of the people, they don't go motion every day. They trouble for going motion free. Yes, you got it? So this condition is called as constipation. This condition is called as what? So constipation. This condition is called as what? Constipation. So constipation problem can be reduced by taking roughages or fibery foods in our daily food items. And some of the roughages rich food items pictures are displayed on the screen. You just please observe. And also, and what you have learnt by this video, you teach this to your friends and your parents. Okay, this is about roughages. Now let me tell you about few important things about the roughages. Roughages, you know, these roughages are present in the peels of the fruits. Most of us, we peel off the fruits and eat, right? Most of us, we peel off the fruits and we eat, but it's not a good habit. Eating along with peel is very good habit, and we get enough fiber in the peels of the fruits, okay, and or enough dietary fiber in peels of the vegetables and peels of the fruits, okay. And moreover, one thing that you have to understand here, most of the farmers who cultivate the fruits and vegetables, they use pesticides, right? They use what? Pesticides. So as they use these pesticides, the pesticides particles remain on the surface of the fruits and vegetables. So if we take directly, if we eat the fruit or vegetables without washing thoroughly, what will happen? You just think about what problems will you get. You will get a lot of problems, okay. So that we have to clean fruits and vegetables thoroughly, and then we have to eat, we have to use that fruits and vegetables as our food. Otherwise we will get health issues. Further, we will get health issues. So that be careful about the fruits and vegetables before you eat. You should wash thoroughly, you should wash, okay, got it? And and one thing that I suggest you to eat fruits along with the peels. Along with what? Peels. So this is the main important thing that we have to remember.